First of all, you're one of my favorite actresses. Let me just tell you, and I'm so happy to hear your voice in a Disney film. You got to tell me, what is that experience like, getting that call and just knowing that you're going to be a part of the Disney lexicon of characters?
It's just a dream come true. This certainly was on my bucket list. And I mean, what way to enter the Disney family with this character? Yes, I mean, she's just groundbreaking.
She is. Now, I talked to the directors earlier this summer, and they were so excited to talk about Yes. Mm-hmm. But talk to me, what stands out about Yes?
I think, for sure, the pink elephant in the room, her fashion,
yes,
her style, her sense of style. But, you know, she's a woman who understands this world of internet. She understands what it is to make a video go viral. I don't think I quite understand that. So she's like this genius, and I think that's good that it's a woman.
They also told me that you guys had a lot of free reign to kind of like riff off the script and stuff, and that Yes kind of had somewhat of a foot fetish for Ralph. Is this true?
Yes, she talked about his feet. I mean, look at them. They're there. They're prevalent. They're right there.
They definitely
they
are.
They cracked up. I don't know. I just had this thing for his feet, and I just comment on them.
How did you personally connect to Yes? Because she is a boss.
She's a boss. You know, the thing about voiceover, I guess that means that I've done enough where people actually have heard my annoying voice to pick it out in a crowd. But I think the first go out is to sound as much like myself as possible,
sure,
so people can identify, oh, that's Taraji, you
right,
know. And maybe later on with the next 10 animated films that I voice over, I can change and play with different sounds.
Yes, spinoff.
Yes, spin-off. Yes, I would love a Yes spinoff.
Now, with the internet being such a big thing, what do you think Yes is to speaking to the internet culture through the audience? What is she trying to say to the internet culture? Yes.
I mean, I think what she's trying to say is be responsible. I mean, you can have fun and you can make things go viral, and Yes, it's all about likes. I thought she taught a great lesson about finances and how you can flip it and make money. And
finances?
Yeah. I mean, you know how you turn those hearts into revenue.
Sure, sure.
Which will help your finances.
It's true.
You know, she is a lot of lessons that she teaches, but I think the most important is to stay out of that comments room. Stay out of the comments, because hurt people hurt people.
I mean, the one thing this movie did so well is creating the internet, but making a visual storytelling for anybody, really.
Yeah.
And staying out of the comments was a big part of this.
Mm-hmm.
What other things do you want people to take away when they see Ralph Breaks the Internet?
I think the most important message in the movie is about unconditional love that you should have for a friend. You know, no matter if they agree with you on everything, you're not going to agree with each other on everything. And they may choose a path in life that you aren't very fond of, but what can you do? If you love the person, you support them, you know, and you help them along the way. And I think that's a beautiful relationship that they have created and bond that they've created between Vanellope and Ralph.
All of you guys seem to have great chemistry together, at mm-hmm. least your voices. Were you guys in the same booth recording all together?
I was with John C. Reilly,
okay,
especially for the scene when he ends up, finds himself in the comment section.
And that's where you guys sparked the foot
fetish
conversation.
Yeah, it really, there was a difference. That was the first time that I'd ever, that I was in a studio with anyone. Before that day, it was just me by myself with Rich and Phil. And they did a really good impersonation of of Ralph, but. And Vanellope. But it's nothing like the real thing,
sure,
you know? And I think we needed it for that scene, because that scene, to me, weighted the movie. It, you know, it weighted the movie, and it gave it compassion, and certainly gave Yes compassion.
When you look back now and you can take away something from Yes that you can advance with you and your career, what mm-hmm. would that be? Turn hearts into money.
Hey, yes! Yes. Well, that's what I do, you know? If you love Taraji, you go to the box office and see me.